प्रयागराज इन वर्चुअल मोड. डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स जमशेदपुर फील्स प्राउड टू होस्ट द ऑनलाइन इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस रापा 2021. नाउ वी विल हैव आवर ट्रेडिशनल एंड प्रोपिशियस सरस्वती वंदना एज अ ट्रिब्यूट टू मदर सरस्वती द गॉडेस ऑफ नॉलेज.
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो नमः. या कुन्देन्दुतुषारहारधवला या शुभ्रवस्त्रावृता या वीणावरतण्डमण्डितकरा या श्वेतपद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युतशङ्करप्रभृतिभिः देवैः सदा वन्दिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेषजाड्याः. शुक्लं ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमा माद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभयदां जाड्यान्धकारापहाम् हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थिताम् वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां. थैंक यू.
हाँ बोलो.
थैंक यू मीनाक्षी. नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी एंड कन्वीनर ऑफ कॉन्फ्रेंस डॉक्टर रत्नेश कुमार मिश्रा असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एनआईटी जमशेदपुर फॉर वेलकम एड्रेस. प्लीज सर.
थैंक यू प्रिया. Greetings to one and all. It gives me immense warmth and great pleasure to grace your presence in the interest of the entire committee. The responsibility to present the welcome speech amongst the most esteemed personalities who have won accolades in their respective fields provides me a feeling of tremendous contentment. Before we begin this conference, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to each and every individual who contributed sincerely for the accomplishment of the event. Without their valuable support, this event would have been very similar to the situation of finding a needle in the stack of hay. Algebra, an intellectual instrument, was created to render the quantitative aspects of the world, as stated by Alfred North Whitehead. Algebra is not just a part of mathematics, it is the soul of it. The conference provides an online platform to undergraduate, postgraduate, PhD students, and as well as faculty members to learn and discuss various recent advances in pure and applied algebra. Total of 453 participants registered in this conference from all over India and 9 other countries. We received 100 plus abstracts, in which 91 have been shortlisted for the presentation. We are obliged having 18 speakers and one award fellowship professor from all over the world. The conference proceeding will be published by Springer Nature, and also selected papers will appear in a special issue of Palestine Journal of Mathematics, that is the Scopus Index Journal after peer review. I ensure that the conference will be very profitable and fruitful for everyone present here. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I request to IAPS representative Dr. Avnish Kumar Chaturvedi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, University of Allahabad, for few words. Please, sir.
Thank you. At the outset, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to the Executive Council for nominating me as IAPS representative for one of its 25th conferences under the umbrella of CONIAPS 27, which are scheduled to be held at 25 different universities, institutions across India during October 26 to 28, 2021. I congratulate the Department of Mathematics, NIT Jamshedpur, Jharkhand, for organizing the conference CONIAPS 27 on recent advances in pure and applied algebra. It is the second consecutive year when international conference of the International Academy of Physical Sciences, CONIAPS 27, is being organized in online mode. The reason we all know is COVID-19 pandemic. I hope the next conference in 2022 would be held with the physical presence of the participants. It is a privilege and an honor for me on this momentous occasion to welcome all the eminent speakers and participants who have joined this online platform to exchange their experience and research work. It is a matter of great honor for us to have Professor Ramji Lal, IIIT Allahabad, former professor and head Department of Mathematics, University of Allahabad, as the chief guest of this inaugural session. Now I would like to brief about the IAPS to all the eminent speakers and participants of CONIAPS 27. Friends, as all of us know that the science generates solutions for everyday life and helps us to answer the great mysteries of the universe. In other words, science is one of the most important channels of knowledge. It has a specific role as well as a variety of functions for the benefit of our society, in creating new knowledge, improving education, and increasing the quality of our lives. Keeping in view these facts, International Academy of Physical Sciences was founded with its headquarters at Allahabad on December 4, 1994 to meet the above goals and objectives. The Academy is conceived as a scientific body incorporating various branches of physical, mathematical, and earth sciences such as physics, chemistry, mathematics, statistics, geology, geophysics, geography, computer science, informatics, biochemistry, biophysics, etc., and the areas of biological sciences which interact with these streams. Thus, the main focus of the Academy is to promote interdisciplinary research, which is also the need of the hour. As per the constitution of IAPS, the administration, direction, and management of the affairs of the Academy are entrusted to an executive council. The Academy organizes international conference on annual basis with the broad name, the brand name CONIAPS. The CONIAPS is one of the key activities of the International Academy of Physical Sciences to bring galaxy of subject experts from mathematics, physics, chemistry, earth sciences, and computational science at a common platform. The glorious record of the Academy is reflected from its seminal encouragement to the young as well as established researchers and scientists through its various awards. The Academy gives recognition to the extraordinary contribution of the researchers by felicitating them with awards in the categories of Gold Medal of the Academy, Fellowship Honor, Honorary Fellowship of IAPS, Swami Bhajanand Saraswati Vedic Science Award, एसोसिएट फेलोशिप ऑफ आईएपीएस, प्रोफेसर एचपी दीक्षित मेमोरियल अवार्ड, प्रोफेसर पीआर शर्मा मेमोरियल अवार्ड एंड आईएपीएस यंग साइंटिस्ट अवार्ड. द एकेडमी हैज ऑल्सो इस्टेब्लिश्ड टू मेमोरियल लेक्चर्स. प्रोफेसर आर एस मिश्रा मेमोरियल लेक्चर इन द मेमोरी ऑफ इमिनेंट मैथमेटिशियन पद्मश्री प्रोफेसर आर एस मिश्रा, हु हैज ऑल्सो बीन द फाउंडर पैटर्न ऑफ द आईएपीएस. प्रोफेसर टी पति मेमोरियल लेक्चर इन द मेमोरी ऑफ एमिनेंट मैथमेटिशियन प्रोफेसर टी पति, द फर्स्ट गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट एंड फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द आईएपीएस. द फेलोशिप ऑफ आईएपीएस, द सेकेंड हाइएस्ट अवार्ड ऑफ आईएपीएस, वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1996 to acknowledge the outstanding contributions in the field of physical sciences. To date, the Academy has conferred the fellowship of IAPS to 70 eminent researchers. Among these 70 fellows of IAPS, 19 are from abroad, belonging to USA, France, Japan, Poland, Canada, Czech Republic, Italy, Thailand, and Nepal. The Academy instituted the Young Scientist Award in the year 1997 to promote the acknowledge the potential of young researchers up to the age of 35. To date, 74 young researchers have been given the Young Scientist Award. The philosophy of the Academy is not only to promote modern sciences, but also has concerned the promotion of Vedic sciences. In this regard, Swami Bhajanand Saraswati Vedic Science Award was instituted in 2010. To date, 4 distinguished thinkers and researchers have been given this award. One of the notable names is Holiness Jagatguru Shankaracharya Swami Nishalananda Saraswati Ji Maharaj of Puri Peetham, who has blessed this award by accepting it. For the holistic development and promotion of research, encouragement to researchers of all age groups is the demand of the hour. With this cognitive belief, the Academy has started IAPS Associate Fellow Award in 2018 to promote potential researchers. To encourage the researchers up to age of 45, the Academy established 2 more awards in the field of mathematics in 2018 and 2019, respectively. These awards are named as Professor S.P. Dixit Memorial Award and Professor P.R. Sharma Memorial Award, and till date, 3 researchers have given this award. For the promotion of interdisciplinary science researches, the Academy provides a platform with its journal in the areas of physical sciences. The Academy is publishing Journal of International Academy of Physical Sciences continuously since 1997. This journal is a peer-reviewed journal, publishes quality research papers without charging any fees. During its journey of 27 years, the Academy has achieved many milestones. The annual conferences of IAPS have traveled to every state of the country. Besides it, 2 conferences were held abroad at Thanyaburi, Thailand in 2012 and Kathmandu, Nepal in 2018. The Academy celebrated its Silver Jubilee in the year 2019 magnificently with profuse academic activities throughout the country. There were 29 academic events organized in this series of the academic events, which was concluded at the 25th International Conference of International Academy of Physical Sciences at Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar, Haryana, during 28 to 30 December 2019. Due to COVID-19 pandemic in the year 2020, the Kenya's 26 was organized under online mode in association with 10 prestigious universities institution across India. On behalf of the IAPS committee, I extend my thanks to the director, NIT Jamshedpur, registrar and administrative staff, DSW faculty members of the Department of Mathematics, NIT Jamshedpur, and all the members of the organizing committee for organizing this conference. Let me now close by wishing you a delightful and stimulating 3 days of the conference. Once again, welcome and thank you all for your online presence and valuable contributions during the conference. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for letting us know more about IAPS and CONYAPS. Atithi Devo Bhava means guest is equivalent to God. A very warm welcome to Professor Ashish Srivastava, St. Louis University, USA. We are very thankful to you, sir, You took the time out of your busy schedule, especially during the late night hours in USA. Sir has done MSc in Mathematics and MTech in Computer Applications from IIT Delhi. He has also done PhD from Ohio University, Athens, Ohio, under the supervision of distinguished Professor S.K. Jain. Dr. Ashish is a professor of mathematics at St. Louis University. His research interest includes non-commutative algebra, combinatorics, and mathematical physics. He has published more than 40 research papers in highly recognized journals. He has published 2 research monographs, one from Oxford University Press and the other under London Mathematical Society Lecture Notes series of Cambridge University Press. His research is partially funded by a Siemens Foundation grant. His keen interest is in the issues of diversity, equity and inclusion in universities and human rights of accommodations. He is also an active member of American Mathematical Society Committee on Human Rights of Mathematicians. He has supervised 3 PhDs. Dissertations and have collaborated with 30 different mathematicians from all over the globe. I request sir to enlighten the audience with his precious words as we begin with the conference. Please, sir.
And I'm very happy to see all of you virtually. The only good thing that has come out of this global pandemic is that we realized our ability to connect virtually. I don't know much about this conference series and this organizing body, I must admit that. But whenever there is an opportunity to see faces from India, I don't miss that. So I'm very happy to be here. I hope that this conference inspires young students, researchers, and I look forward to my own talk. I don't know, maybe it is tomorrow or tomorrow night. So thank you once again.
Thank you, sir.
We are very thankful to you, sir, for giving us your valuable time and kind words. Thank you. It is a matter of great pleasure that we have with us Professor Vinay Kumar, ex-scientist E and Technical Director, National Informatics Center, Government of India. Sir has completed his MCA from JNU, New Delhi, and PhD from Delhi University. He has worked as ex-scientist E and Technical Director for National Informatics Center, Government of India. He had also served the position of Dean and Professor in VIP New Delhi. Last but not the least, he is the founder of DHEI Research Foundation New Delhi. He has published several research papers in reputed journals. His achievement does not end here. His research paper entitled Proof of Beale's Conjecture and Fermat-Last Theorem Using Contrapositive Method was published in iManager's Journal on Mathematics in 2018, in view of the fact that so many eminent mathematicians were unable to prove Fermat's last theorem. He has published 2 books, one Killed Instinct and the other Discrete Mathematics. We would like to take this opportunity to do the honors. I request Professor Vinay Kumar to kindly address us. Please, sir.
Thank you very much for such a illustrious introduction. Time is short and I hope we have to wind up. So just I will take very brief. First I will just welcome all these respected eminent guests, the respected organizer of this conference, the participant researchers, the student volunteers who are working so nicely to make this conference successful, all the august audience of this conference who are participating during this inaugural session. The conference, the topic is so relevant over here, and if I go by its name, that is the recent advances in the pure and applied algebra. It's so relevant in the present context, and I wish, you know, such conferences brings the thought and works presented in this conference from the classroom of the teaching or in the library to the real field of the application. The mathematics, the tragedy that it is thought even today, though we are using this the video conferencing, and we all may be or must be knowing a lot of mathematics is involved in giving the practical shape to this application. Right from the sampling of the whatever the voice we are speaking, from the analog to digital, compressing using the various compressing techniques, and then transmitting over this public network, all involves mathematics in one way or the other. So the idea of this conference should be to whatever the thought, a lot of thoughts are generated during the conferences in the form of the presentation, in form of the writing of the paper, but most of the time, it remains as a, some pages of the nicely published journal or the books. So the idea should be to really translate or transfer this knowledge generated during the conference to the actual fields. The application of mathematics should must demonstrate, and the once it is brought to the field, it really generates a lot of interest into the common people to learn about this mathematics. The unknowingly or knowingly, we all, in fact, the all living beings in this nature, use mathematics in one way or the other way in the real life. For example, the very simple example I'll give, you know, during our school day, in the class 3, in the class 4, in the class 5, while solving the equation, the algebraic equation, we were taught the conciliation of the common multiplicative or the additive factors. But none of us were taught, you know, this conciliation is possible because of the properties of the group which we were taught in at the graduation level. So such a transition means, you know, we use it without knowing the actual, you know, this is a part of the higher mathematics. So I wish, you know, such type of conferences will generate knowledge, and the knowledge will get translated and the transferred to the field, the way we are using all this. This is the computational mathematics in the form of this video conferencing, the compression, the transmission, the sampling, the modulation, and so on. And again, in the algebraic, like the coding and the what you call encryption. So that should be, you know, idea should be there. So I will encourage, you know, all the participants and researchers should work in this way, present the paper and then convert this into the real application. And at the end, I wish all the best to the organizer and the participant for the grand success of this conference. And I hope this conference will certainly bring a good set of knowledge, which will get translated into the real application in the coming day. Thank you very much for giving me time to express this one. Hope I will participate on the 20th as a keynote speaker on the algebraic number theory, and then I will get time to speak on that. Thank you very much to all the organizers.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your kind words. As we can see, our director, sir, has also joined. We welcome you, sir. Now, I heartily welcome our honorable guest, Professor Shivdutt Kumar, MN NIT Allahabad, Prayagraj. Sir has done his PhD from HRI Allahabad, Prayagraj, and under the supervision of distinguished Professor Ram Jilal and Professor Satya Mandal, Kansas University, USA. He has also served as the head Department of Mathematics, Motilal Nehru National Institute of Technology, Allahabad, from September 1, 2011 to August 31, 2013. Currently, he is a professor in Mathematics Department and Chief Warden at MNNIT Allahabad. He has also worked as visiting scientist at the Johann Radon Institute for Computational and Applied Mathematics, Linz, Austria, in 2006. He received Mathematics Research Fellowship at the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics, Trieste, Italy, in 2004, 2008, and 2009. I request sir to speak a few words about his endeavors and his experiences. Please, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Good morning to all. Professor K.K. Shukla, Director, NIT Jamshedpur. Professor Ram Jilal sir, my teacher. Professor Tarni Mandal. Dr. Avnish Chaturvedi, Dr. Ashish Srivastav, Dr. Sunil Kumar Head, and Ratnesh Kumar Mishra, convener. Delegates, invited speakers, distinguished faculty members, guests, and my dear students, good morning to all. Mathematics is basically related to understanding structure. It is used to do logical analysis, make relevant calculations, and eventually to deduce conclusions and patterns. Mathematics is a language of science. Mathematics is unavoidable. It is deeply fundamental. Mathematics is the basis of all fields of science and technology. If we go down deep into anything, we'll find mathematics. Many of the breakthrough scientific inventions which found tremendous technological applications at later stages emerged from fundamental mathematical principles. The advent of high-speed digital computers has been a boon to the engineers and technologists for solving complex problems arising from mathematical modeling and simulations of practical system. Mathematics is everywhere in our life, but many applications are not visible to the normal public. Technology uses digital communications in which satellites play a key role. At the back of this technology, the driving force is the coding theory, where finite fields are used, which is a part of abstract algebra. Algebra is one of the core areas in mathematics. Algebra has wide applications to several areas. In particular, post-quantum cryptography is based on lattices, codes, polynomials. In coding theory, there are many algebraic codes such as cyclic codes, quadratic residue codes, Gopa codes, and algebraic geometry codes. Algebraic graph theory involves the study of graphs in connection with the linear algebra and a spectrum of adjacency matrix. Cayley graphs are based on groups as well. The DNA codes are based on four alphabets A, C, G, and T, so that the rings with four elements are used for the construction of DNA codes. Machine learning is about estimating functions from data. Machine learning techniques are based on algebraic representation of data. Linear algebra is a standard prerequisite in machine learning and artificial intelligence. For example, dimensionality reduction techniques such as principal component analysis require a basic understanding of projections that relies on spectral theorem. So PCA is one of the most commonly used unsupervised machine learning algorithm across a variety of applications. One of the most applications of algebra is in the representation theory. We can deal with the symmetric groups as matrices. This idea leads to revolution in quantum mechanics. Linear algebra has vast applications in all fields of mathematics and in applied mathematics and applied science and technology. Linear algebra is very useful in the study of anything in the space due to particle moving in the space in different directions. It has applications in image processing and compressing. Each image is made up of relatively large number of small squares called pixels or image elements, and linear algebra techniques are used to increase image compression or rebuild. Another application is in image processing, such as optimization, restoration, and segmentation. Each image can be represented as an n class n matrix, and then linear algebra is used. In public communication, cryptography is used for protecting information transmitted through public communication. In cryptography, large prime numbers and Euler theorems are used, which is a generalization of Fermat theorem, and again a part of algebra. With electronic communications and transactions becoming the norm, solid encryption methods are essential. Most such methods involve advanced mathematics. One of the simpler encoding methods use matrix transformation, modular arithmetic to encode, decode messages. These codes are called linear codes. They rely on generator matrix and a parity check matrix, for example, Hamming codes. So linear algebra has applications in electrical circuits, genetic and cryptography, polygraphic system. There are applications of eigenvalues in stability in control systems. Game theory is used to model two-player games requiring the same decision to be made at each step. Linear algebra is used to describe the situation. Matrix theory has been very successful in describing interrelations among prices, outputs, and demands in economic systems. One application of the algebra is in oil and gas to analyze acoustic data gathered during oil exploration. Geophysicists will use algorithms like full waveform inversion. This algorithm needs to invert and process a very large matrix, about 200,000 to 2,000,000, usually using parallel processing supercomputers. In machine learning, one can consider group transformations, on images to get a representation of the image that is invariant to those transformations. The intersection of planes and lines leads to linear equations and thus to kernels of linear maps. The area of parallelograms and thus to triangles can be computed in terms of determinants. Many surfaces in computer graphics are constructed from triangles. In image processing, improvement techniques are based on applying the filters to the image, which is simply an application of linear map. Singular value decomposition is widely used for image processing. In discrete Fourier transform, the discrete Fourier transform can be represented by a unitary matrix and is frequently used in image processing. The application of eigenvalues and eigenvectors in Google original page rank algorithm is a good example. The idea is to rebuild a matrix. So it is the exactness of mathematics which enables us to calculate accurately the large distances between the stars and planets and to measure the magnitude of size of atoms or nanomaterials. These are some glimpses of applications of mathematics. In GPS, mathematics of spherical geometry is used. In cancer treatment, mathematics is involved through a number of optimal size helmets. Mathematics is like an ocean, which is a rough, boisterous, and fearful on the surface, but having precious pearls and genies of the purest ray seen at the bottom. Innovative research in all fields of science and technology are recognized as major drivers of social and economic development. With the growth of scientific and technological development, it is necessary to have such platforms which provides exposure of the recent development to young generations. Conference is an effort to promote the scientific environment culture in creating awareness regarding the advances in mathematical science. I'm sure that this conference will be a great success. I take this opportunity to congratulate the organizer of the conference, Dr. Ratnesh Parmeshwara, and Professor K.K. Shukla for his dynamic leadership. and I wish grand success. At the end, I recite the sloka from Rig Veda. Ano bhadra katyo yantu viswatah. Let good thoughts or knowledge come from everywhere, from all the world. With these words, I thank all the present. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words and letting us know about the applications of linear algebra more. We would like to hear you more from in keynote addresses.
Thank you. Now
I'm glad to respectfully and cordially welcome the honorable guest, Dr. Nutan Kumar, sir, IIT Patna. Sir has done his MSc and PhD from IIT Roorkee. He received DAAD Research Fellow from Department of Engineering Mathematics, University of Bayreuth, Germany in 2008. Currently, he is an associate professor in Mathematics Department, IIT Patna. He has successfully completed two projects, one from CSIR New Delhi in 2014 and other from NPOL DRDO India in 2017. He is also an active member of different professional bodies like Indian Mathematical Society and Indian Society of Industrial and Applied Mathematicians. He has also received Best Teacher Award in IIT Patna. We are very thankful to you, sir, for giving us the valuable time from your busy schedule. Without wasting any time, I would like to invite sir to kindly address us. Please, sir. Since sir is not able to make it now, so he has sent us his voice note. Can we play that?
Friends, algebra is one of the main branches of mathematics. Hello everyone. I am delighted to know that the Department of Mathematics, IIT Jamshedpur, is organizing the International Conference on Recent Advances in Pure and Applied Algebra in association with the Academy of Physical Sciences, Prayagraj. As per the list of speakers, I see that this conference will assemble the experts in the field of algebra. Friends, algebra is one of the main branches of mathematics. It starts with the elementary arithmetic rules and then abstractions make it more powerful. We can solve hundreds of thousands of problems at the same time with the power of abstraction. Nowadays, different branches of algebra are playing an essential role in many applied fields like control theory, coding theory, cryptography, and artificial intelligence, to name a few. I sincerely hope that this conference will deliberate and discuss all the different aspects of these exciting topics. I'm sorry that I am not present in this opening ceremony program due to some urgent personal issues. But through this audio message, I extend my sincere appreciation to the organizers of the conference. I wish the conference great success. Thank you.
We thank you, sir, for your words. Now, I would like to welcome Professor T. Mandal, Dean, Student Welfare, NIT Jamshedpur. Sir, please share a few words to the audience.
Thank you. A very good morning to one and all present here. Honorable Director Professor K.K. Shukla, coordinator of the program Dr. Ratnesh Kumar Mishra, Dr. Mahendra Kumar Gupta, all the members of the Dean panel, all the revered keynote speakers present on this occasion, Professor and my dear students. It is my greatest pleasure and honor that I have the chance of saying few words on this auspicious occasion. International Conference on Recent Advance in Pure and Applied Algebra is the 27th conference in the procession. Every year organize this conference to discuss and review the recent advance in pure and applied mathematics. My dear friends and students, mathematics is the language of world. It is an art form in itself. The way one create subject that have the potential of unraveling and secrets of this universe by just using numbers and concept is amazing. Mathematics is a rational and at the same time artistic but and beautiful like a painting. There are some abstract emotion of my own associated with this scientific and logical subject. That's why I feel that a conference like this will help us unfold the new secrets and blank on the development that took place recently in the massive pool. Algebraic mathematics is something that we have been studying since our childhood, associating a number with a random variable and then formulating equation is something that all of us have done. But we can feel the true potential of algebra only when we go through its mathematical models. I feel that this conference was neat for that. I am really fortunate that I have been given a chance to speak here. I now will talk about the subject a bit more. The purpose of algebra is to make it easy to state a mathematical relationship and its equation by using letters of the alphabet or other symbols to represent entities as a form of shorthand. Algebra then allow us to substitute value in order to solve the equation for the unknown quantities. In everyday life, we use algebra quite frequently in our everyday lives and without even realizing it. Learning algebra helps to develop our critical thinking skills that includes problem solving, logistic, logic, patterns, and reasoning. Why not only use algebra, but we also actually need algebra to solve most of our problems that involves calculations. I feel proud on T, recent advance in pure and applied algebra for conducting international conference. In last, my wish to organize team to organize this conference successfully. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time and kind words. Now, may I now request Dr. Sunil Kumar, chairperson of the conference and head of the department mathematics, NIT Jamshedpur, to kindly address us. Please, sir.
Thank you so much, Pooja Gupta. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, respected director, sir, esteemed chief guest of honor, entire team of this conference, and other dignitaries here. It's my great pleasure to welcome you all to the opening of the recent Advance in Pure and Applied Mathematics, an international conference in the Department of Mathematics, NIT Jamshedpur. The most respected director, sir, honorable chief guest, respected deans, all HODs, colleagues, and all dear participants, you are most welcome in this memorable occasion. It is a great joy and satisfaction that Department of Mathematics and NIT Jamshedpur is organizing 3 days online international conference on recent advances in pure and applied algebra under the leadership of Dr. Ratnesh Kumar Mishra. The Department of Mathematics is one of the leading departments of our institute in research as well as in teaching. The Department of Mathematics offers various courses such as PhD program in various disciplines of pure and applied mathematics, MSc in mathematics. In addition to this, supporting compulsory basic courses of engineering mathematics of all branch BTech programs The Department of Mathematics comprises of highly competent faculty member, including one professor, 3 associate professor, and 7 young and very dynamic assistant professor in various research areas. Each faculty is actively engaged in research and teaching both. On the behalf of our department, I'm happy to inform you that the department has 6 national sponsored research projects to its credit funded by DST, NBHM, SAR, and DRDO, Government of India. On the behalf of our department, again, I'm happy to say that Department of Mathematics has completed one international project on COVID entitled Mathematical Modeling of the Pandemic Coronavirus Outbreak through Fractional Derivative with collaboration of Ajman University. Further, it's my great pleasure to inform you that Department of Mathematics has just started another international major research project, a mathematical modeling based on infectious deadly disease model by using fractional derivative, which is ongoing project. Apart from teaching and research, faculty members of the department are actively involved in administration, training, and other activities for all-round development of the institute. Today is the special day. We are happy to organize this 3-day online international conference. I am thanking very much to our honorable director, sir, our honorable director, Professor K. K. Shukla, sir, for his continuous support and guidance to our department. To conclude my remarks, ladies and gentlemen, I thanks to the all participants of 3-day online international conference on recent advance in pure and applied algebra. I wish to all the best to the organizer to make this workshop a real success. I sincerely hope you will enjoy the next 3 days of debate and networking. Thank you for your kind participation. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words. I am profusely overjoyed to take the opportunity to invite our Honorable Director, Professor K.K. Shukla. Sir has motivated all of us as a live example of kindness and selfless service to our institute as well as nation. Sir has given his best by sharing his expertise and knowledge in every possible way to us. Now, I would like to request Sir to kindly bless us with his kind word. Please, Sir.
Thank you, Pooja, for your kind words. Good morning to all of you. Respected Professor Ramji Lal, chief guest of the inaugural function of this conference on recent advances in pure and applied mathematics being organized under the aegis of International Academy of Physical Sciences. Guest of honors, Professor Ashish Srivastava, Professor Vinay Kumar, Professor Sivdat Kumar, Professor Nutan Kumar, organizing secretaries, Dr. Ratnesh, Dr. Mahendra, head of the department, Dr. Sunil Kumar, dear delegates, keynote speakers, invited speakers, a warm welcome to all of you in virtual mode to NIT Jamshedpur. I'm very happy to note that relatively a very young and dynamic department. Why I'm calling young? If you count the average age of the faculty, so I may find that this may be the one of the youngest department in this institute. That's why I'm coining this word young and dynamic. Dynamism I'm coining because as the head has already told you about the activities, different activities going on in the department. So let me congratulate the whole mathematics department of NIT Jamshedpur for conducting such a wonderful event in the name of International Conference on a very relevant subject. I was listening to Professor Binay, Professor Sevdat, and others regarding the importance of the mathematics and particularly the algebra. Yes, it's true that mathematics now it has become the integral part of the life. If I have to say, I'm a man of, I do work in solid mechanics. So we coin different areas of the mechanics. You can call it experimental mechanics, you can call it analytical mechanics, theoretical mechanics, or computational mechanics. Everywhere mathematics is involved. Even though you conduct series of experiments, then and after that you have to analyze the data, be it regression analysis or whatever. So mathematics comes into existence everywhere. Whatever the area of the technology you talk about, Professor Siddharth already talked about, and Professor Binner, I was listening to him about the compression mathematics, real application. If you see the number theory, that has given a boost to the computer encryptions. So whatever the area you talk about, be it civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, whatever it is, everywhere mathematics is involved. And as a technologist, whatever we do, we make a mathematical model of a physical system. We conceive a physical system and we make a mathematical model. And wherever you go, you will land up to either the algebraic equations, linear or nonlinear algebraic equations, the mathematical model of any physical system, or if it is discrete. And if the system is continuous, then you will land up to the differential equations. Again, depending upon the complexity of the system, you will find whether it is ordinary differential equation, partial differential equation, coupled, uncoupled, linear, nonlinear, so on. So whatever you do, you have to land up to some mathematical model. And this is the challenge for the engineers, to give us the solution for those mathematical models. So my dear friends, everywhere the mathematics comes into existence. Without the existence of mathematics, I believe that technology would have not taken so far. So with the advancement in the technological field, whatever you call it, whether synthesizing, characterization, or testing, everywhere in one or other form, mathematics come into existence. So I believe that the researchers, academicians, and the students participating in this conference will enrich their knowledge base by listening to their peers. I was going through the brochure of the conference. I'm very happy to note that the organizers have meticulously planned, and they have invited the speakers across the globe. So you will have a galaxy of the experts, and whatever you are, in other words, you can call that you will have an opportunity to listen to your peers. So this is one of the positive outcome of the conferences, such conferences, which different institutions, organizations organize. Not only you have to showcase your talent, you have to present your research, your thought processes in the open forum to the audience, to the different persons working in this area. Simultaneously, you get an opportunity to interact, to listen, and to learn many more things. So this should not end up to presenting the paper, listening to the peers. We should take the place from here onwards that we will take the mathematics, be it pure or applied, whatever we call, wherever the mathematics come, it has to be applied. Nobody has thought that when the number theory was evolved, that this will have a great significance. So it will have a great significance either today or day after tomorrow. So please carry on this mission of mathematics for enhancing the quality of the life indirectly. At the end, I am tempted with a sloka. I will carry forward what Siddharth ji has said. Why this conference? Why we should acquire the knowledge? It is a continuous process. With this sloka, I will end my talk. that na chorahariyam na cha rajharyam na bhrativrajyam na cha bharkari vyayakrite vardat eva nityam vidyadhanam sarvadhanam pradhanam. Neither it can be stolen by thieves, nor it can be taken away by the king, nor it can be divided among the brothers, but nor it can be bothered about the weight by the weight, that your knowledge increases, your weight will increase. So gravity law works in the field of knowledge in different way, in reverse way. As you acquire the knowledge, you will feel that you are becoming enlightened. Enlightening means very simple, more simpler or lighter in the sense. So knowledge weight does not add to the gravity, it acts in the reverse direction of the gravity. And why this conference and people like Binaji or Asis Srivastavaji or somebody who are sharing his knowledge, that if you share the knowledge, it will increase in many fold. So please do carry on this torch of organizing conferences, sharing the knowledge, and taking to the next height of research, in particular for development of new technologies and many more. Once again, I congratulate Department of Mathematics and IT Jamshedpur and the organizers. Again, the young and dynamic fellow, Dr. Ratnesh and Dr. Mahendra, whom I can see on the screen. Many congratulations to both of you for organizing this conference and giving the opportunity of young researchers of NIT Jamshedpur and other institutions to share their knowledge. Thank you. Please take care. I wish a grand success for this conference and love to see many more in coming days. Thank you. Take care. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving us your valuable time and kind words. Thank you for inspiring us. We hope by this conference, our participants and attendees will try to gain more and more from this conference. Now, I'm feeling very fortunate to announce about our next speaker. It is a matter of great pleasure that we have an eminent personality among us, a great mathematician, or we say a renowned algebraist, Professor Ramji Lal. Professor Ramji Lal is an adjunct professor at the Department of Mathematics, IIIT, Allahabad. He started his research career at the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai, and served the University of Allahabad in different capacities for over 43 years as a professor, head of department, and the coordinator of the DSA program. He was associated with Harish Chandra Research Institute, Allahabad, where he initiated a postgraduate program in mathematics and coordinated the Nurture Program of National Board for Higher Mathematics from 1996 to 2000. After his retirement from the University of Allahabad, he was an advisor cum adjunct professor at the Indian Institute of Information Technology, Allahabad, for over 3 years. After IIIT Allahabad, he served as an adjunct professor at the Harish Chandra Research Institute, Allahabad, Uttar Pradesh. Now, without wasting any time, I heartily welcome our honorable chief guest to bless us with his kind words. Please, sir.
Thank you, Pooja, for your kind words with me. And a very good morning to all of you present over here. Let me first thank the director, Professor Kanwar Kumar Shukla, Dr. Sunil Kumar, and Dr. Ratnesh Mishra, and the organizing committee over here for inviting me to this inaugural function. It gives me extreme pleasure to be here and share a few words with all of you. Now, I've seen Professor Shivdat, Professor Kanwar Kumar Shukla, and indeed everybody has said a lot about the applications of mathematics. Indeed, mathematics is central in all branches of knowledge. And further, algebra is central in mathematics. As a result,
algebra is central in all branches of knowledge, I would say. But I have some, the very outset, let me first express my little discomfort about the terminology pure and applied algebra. This pure algebra, the algebra is always pure. I am a little uncomfortable about the term pure algebra. Once we use the term pure algebra, it immediately gives the feeling that some part of algebra is impure. The applied algebra is also pure. What we may perhaps say, that talk about the part of algebra which has been applied so far as applied algebra. This is still is annoying, as all algebraic developments had its roots in its applications and played central role everywhere. Indeed, I believe the assertion, to every consistent mathematical theory, there is a physical phenomena associated to that, whether we are able to observe it or not. So it is the mathematics, you know, it's based on the axioms and consistent set of axioms. And if you believe in this assertion, to every mathematical theory, there is bound to be a physical phenomena which is observable or not. So I believe in that assertion. Remember, when Gauss termed his reciprocity theorem as his best theorem, the golden theorem, there was a criticism from all corners of scientific community, scientific world, especially physicists, as number theory was supposed to be the most non-applicable branch at that time. But now it has become highly applicable in security, as mathematics has played a pivotal role in all branches of engineering, social science, and algebra has played a central role in all branches of mathematics, be it geometry. A parameterized family of linear algebra can be described as geometry. Geometry is purely a parameterized family of linear algebra. At every point, you talk of tangent and how the tangent varies. Tangent varies if you move from one point to the other. That's really geometry. So the geometry is a parameterized family of linear algebra, I would say. So be it geometry or be it topology, homotopy, homology theory, and many more algebraic structures play a very crucial role in solving the problems of in classifying indeed the topological structures. Be it mechanics, linear algebra plays a very central role in mechanics. Mechanics, of course, is more or less geometry. So therefore, the algebra is there. You know, and be it computer science, Boolean algebra, binary arithmetic, as everybody has talked about, plays central role in computer science. Indeed, John von Neumann, the great mathematician, was first to conceive the idea of computer science. Thus, algebra is central in all branches of knowledge. I am extremely happy that Mathematics Department in IIT Jamshedpur is holding a conference on the central branch of knowledge with algebra, mainly algebra. I wish grand success for the conference. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Your presence and wise words helped magnify our cause in the best possible way. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for taking time from your busy schedule to be the chief guest of our conference. Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to invite Dr. M.K. Gupta, Organizing Secretary of the conference, for a vote of thanks. Please, sir.
Good morning, everyone. I, Dr. Mahendra Kumar Gupta, feel honored and lucky to have the opportunity to deliver a vote of thanks on this special day. At first, I would take the opportunity to thank all the guest speakers for sharing their valuable experiences with us. I would like to thank our director, sir, for sharing his expertise and knowledge with us. I would also like to thank all the members of the organizing team, teachers, staff members who have contributed to this conference. Student volunteers have worked hard to come to this point. Finally, I would like to thank you all once again for the successful start of this event. Thank you, everyone. Over to Pooja.
Yes, sir. Now, I would like to request everyone to pay respect to our nation and to all the soldiers who fought fearlessly to earn this freedom. May I request you all to stand up and sing together the national anthem, please.